Well, Philippine police are verifying reports that the online message board 8chan is operating out of the Philippines. Let's talk now to Police Lieutenant Colonel Elpidio Ramirez. He's the chief of the police cyber patrolling unit. Lieutenant Colonel Ramirez, thank you for taking our call. Thanks for joining us this noon. Welcome to the program.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon.
All right. I want to focus now on the focus of your investigation. What is at the center of your investigation as you investigate 8chan?
Yes, ma'am. We try to get the profile of a website 8chan and also the profile of Frederick Brennan as well as the other administrator of the website.
But Frederick Brennan is already out of it, right? He already sold 8chan to Mr. Watkins.
Yes, ma'am. Since 8chan website was already taken down, we have initial coordination with Mr. Frederick Brennan for his information pertaining to that website.
So in the intro, before we got you on air, I said that you're looking into reports that the online message board is operating out of the Philippines. What leads do you have regarding this? Is it really operating within the Philippines?
We are not sure of that, ma'am.
What are you sure of at this point? Lieutenant Colonel Ramirez, are you still there?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so what are you sure at this point regarding 8chan?
8chan website was already taken, ma'am. We are checking on the profile, but the image board, we cannot even see the image posted at the 8chan website, ma'am.
So it's already been taken down, is that what you're saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Since when?
We are not sure, ma'am, but as of our online investigation, we just found out that 8chan website was already taken down, and as per the account of Brennan in his Twitter account, he's denouncing those image board posted in the 8chan.
Mm-hmm. Now, in the event that it's put up again, because sometimes that can happen, it's taken down one day and put up again the next, can your unit recommend that the site be taken down permanently and based on what violations of Philippine laws?
Yes, ma'am. Since the website is full of incitement to violence, we are recommending the total takedown of this website.
All right. So far, have you been able to talk to Mr. Watkins? Has he been cooperating? Do you even know his exact location?
No, ma'am. We have initial coordination with Mr. Frederick Brennan, and he is in his full cooperation to talk with us and answer what are the information that may be wanting.
Mm-hmm. Okay, as a final question, because of the nature of the crimes associated with the site, what kind of international cooperation are you getting? Because this is not just a Philippine issue alone. There is a lot of attention from the world over because of the crimes associated with it. Are you getting help from the U.S.? Are you getting help from anyone else?
Yes, ma'am. We are coordinating with other agencies of the government to make the appropriate measures pertaining to violence using the platform, the social media platform.
Mm-hmm. So is your focus right now to get to Mr. Watkins?
We have no idea or information about Mr. Watkins. What we have started now is our coordination with Frederick Brennan. So I'm sure Frederick Brennan can give us information and details about Mr. Watkins.
Okay, so we're going to have to leave it at that. As we understand, that investigation is at its very early stage. But do keep us posted on whatever developments you may have regarding this. Police Lieutenant Colonel Elpidio Ramirez there. He's the chief of the Philippine Police Cyber Patrolling Unit. We appreciate you taking our call. Thanks for joining us this noon. Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.
Thank you.